Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to take a look at how to set up a character with spring effects in Character Creator 4. Spring effects allow your character to look much more dynamic and realistic, and in many cases are used to generate a cartoon-like energy like you see in these examples. Spring effects can be applied to a number of different bone types, as well as different creatures and props, which we'll discuss in this tutorial. Let's jump right into it with this character, where we'll demonstrate how to add a spring effect to the ears and tail. In the Modify panel, you'll find an Edit Spring button, which will enter us into Edit Spring mode. There, we can hit the button or press F3 to open up the Bone Manager panel. There are currently no bones that can be edited in Edit Spring mode because we need to define some of them as used bones instead of facial or body bones. Let's exit Edit Spring mode for now, and we'll see the character's bone structure appear in the Bone Manager. We can edit the bone properties to a different color so we can see them more clearly. I'm going to select one of the ear bones first, which is defined as a facial bone, indicated by the little head icon beside it. We can convert it to a used bone by clicking the Used button in the Set Bone Type section at the bottom. Once we do, the icon will change to indicate it's a used bone. I'll do the same thing for the other ear bones on the hierarchy, so we can assign them all with spring bone properties. Once that's done, you'll notice that the tail bones don't currently show up because they are defined as unused bones. If we use the filters to show only unused bones, they will show up. Let's follow the same process by selecting all of the tail bones and converting them to used bones. When the bones are defined as used bones, then they can have the spring effect applied to them. Speaking of which, let's see how we can activate the spring bone effect now. If we go into Edit Spring mode now, you'll see the list of used bones appear in the Bone Manager. Let's start with the ears by selecting each bone and activating them all. You want to include the end bone points here too. To test things out, we can use the new animation player. Let's open it up, and in the motion menu, you can see a certain number of motions to test out specific parts of the body. Under body rig, there is one for head and shoulders, which is what we'll use. You can see the effect isn't super noticeable, but it's still there. To tweak it, we can define the type of spring effect. The choices here are Translate and Rotate. Translate will mainly have an effect such as stretching or creating an offset, while Rotate mode will behave more in a waving or rotating manner. In this case, I'm going to define them all as Rotate types and test it out. We can further tweak this effect by using the Hardness parameter, which will determine the elasticity of your spring effect. A higher hardness value will decrease the overall elasticity and make things less bouncy. I can repeat the same process with the tail, again defining them all with rotate spring types. In this case, I'll use a body test motion to test out the results of the tail spring. Okay, let's take a look at the group settings section in Edit Spring mode. Grouping allows you to manage the spring effects by groups as opposed to hierarchy. Here you can see three groups, one for the right ear, one for the left, and one for the tail. The two bones on the left are set in the Coyote L ear group by default as they are connected, as are the ones for the right ear. I'm going to arrange them all into one ear group as I want to share the same effect settings for both ears. So first I'll rename the Coyote L ear group to just Coyote ear. I'll then select the sub-item under the right ear group and move that up on the list by using the Merge Up button, which will place it under the main Coyote ear group. Once they are merged under the Coyote ear group, that means that they are now controlled via the same spring effect settings. You can activate or deactivate the entire group by selecting it and toggling the active group on or off. You can also tweak additional parameters here like mass, strength, and bounciness. These parameters are pretty straightforward. Mass will give the tail more weight, which has a stronger effect depending on momentum. Strength works in tandem with mass to generate more movement, and bounciness will determine how stiff or bouncy the final effect is. Let's take a look at how we can apply this effect to props and other creatures. With custom props, there won't be any perform motions in the animation player for you to test out, but we can import prepared motions for props or creatures into a custom perform list. To do that, we can just open up the perform list editor and select the motion that we've already created in iClone. Once that's added in, we can test it out quickly. If you don't have any motions prepared, you can also use the profile in Prop and Creature Calibration. There are a number of simple preset motions you can use here to test the results. Once you're happy with all the spring settings, you can export it to iClone by simply using the button on the main toolbar at the top. In iClone, you'll find your spring settings at the bottom of the Attributes tab in the Modify panel. Here you'll see the groups we defined earlier, as well as the same three major parameters used to adjust the spring effect. That's about it for this video, guys. Thanks so much for watching, and be sure to check out our forums at forum.reillusion.com, as well as our YouTube channel for more learning resources. I'll see you in the next video.